Get some dewormer and frontline for little Mr. Clover here. I've got a little project I'm working on, Spice Drawer, and Michael's is a pet-friendly store, so we're gonna take him in Michael's for the first time. Are you so excited? Are you excited? Yes? Doesn't he look excited? He actually looks pretty tired, but he's gonna have fun in there, I just know it. Try and get these. Someone's checking the back for me to see if we have them in a box because I don't want to carry all those singles, but if we must. So while he's going to town over there, we got 31 of these jars. They were really much very nice to put them in a box. Yeah, so that you don't have to like break them on the way in, but this is gonna be our project.
Okay, y'all, it's like July 10th. And dude, we're already trying to get rid of summer. What is life? I'm totally not gonna buy this, but look, it's a Clover Beanie Baby.
Clover, look! Look, it's you! It's you! Take a nap. I got all of these jars. They were nice enough to put it in a box and in the bag so I could easily carry it. So the next thing I have to do is wash them all. I didn't even think about that until I got home and I was like, oh man. So that's what we're doing. We're gonna probably grab some lunch and then continue.
Wow. Oh my goodness. That was a lot of them. Look at how many there are. There are so many. I do have a couple of like plain jars that I'm also going to use. So those have all been washed. I'm waiting for them to dry. And in the meantime, I will have my lunch and cuddle with the puppy. He's so tired.
He's like, leave me alone. So tired. All right, take a nap, buddy. All right, so the first thing I have to do before I put the spices in the new containers is actually declutter some of the spices here. Now, there's a limited amount of time that you can keep spices for. It tends to be, I think, maybe like 12 to 18 months. If that is not right, I'll put the correct one in an annotation down here below. But so I'm gonna throw out anything I haven't used within the last 12 or 18 months. I do buy a lot of spices. I do cook a lot and I do use a lot of these. For instance, like cumin, I tend to use a lot, as well as chili powder. So I'm going to go through and declutter these and see what is going on. And I'm gonna put on a little video so I don't get bored. All right, here we go. Okay, so these are still the good ones. There were some that were expired. And here's like an empty, like little acrylic guy. So I'm going to transfer some of these into these, and I will give you a progress report when I am almost done. All right, y'all, here is the scene of the crime. Now, I'm gonna be honest with you and tell you that this was not super fun. It was like really labor intensive. And it is very, very messy. Look at the mess. Look at the mess. These Whole Foods little spice bottles are so hard to get into. You have to like pop the top off. That's why I have this knife out here. This was really challenging. And I've got all of these labels that I was using. I will link them in the description below so that you guys can get them, but they're really great. I used these on the bottom of all the bottles to identify when I should throw them away because I'm getting rid of the original packaging. All right, I'll show you guys how it went. All right, it's time for the big reveal. Here is the new and improved spice drawer. All the bottles are the same, and I still have some empty bottles just in case I need some additional spices. I realized I had fewer that were good than I thought. And up here are the ones I left in the bottle. They're just too big to go in. This is like some sesame seeds, Szechuan pepper, I don't use that much. This is like steak seasoning, and there's some other stuff that's, I just didn't want to pack in yet. Star anise, it was just too big to go in these bottles because they're actually quite small. I didn't actually get all the spices in like of all the packaging. So what I've done is I've put some extra way up here. So if I run out of some of these things, I know where they are hiding. And I never go up there anyway. So here is what happened. I wrote on the bottles what they were in chalk ink. This is like this little guy. I thought it looked super cute. The only thing about this is I do believe it smudges off a little bit. I'm not sure how to make it permanent, but I will investigate. It does rub off and it comes off with like water and stuff like that. It's pretty cool. Anyway, I've written what they are here. I have sort of alphabetized them. They're not perfectly alphabetized, but they're alphabetized enough for me to find whatever is here. Allspice is kind of here hanging out. I hardly ever use this. I use this in like one recipe usually, but I've got all the rest of my spices that I use here. I'm so excited to be able to like find them easily, not have all the different packaging. I've got to fix this. This is actually two things of cumin because cumin is just one of those things I use almost all the time. So yeah, here are all of the spices. I think they look really cute. There is the finished product, you guys. I actually want to mention at the bottom of these jars is where I have this label. Once label's not on that one, but I've put the expiration dates for all of the spices here so I know exactly when I need to get rid of them and buy a new one. Not all of them are written neatly, as you can see. Some of them are a little neater than others. My shirt is actually also super dirty. I got spice all over it, and my vacuum is full of spice. As you can see, I vacuumed everywhere. So I'm gonna get cleaned up and end this video. I hope you guys enjoyed my spice drawer reorganization and refresh. If you guys like this video, please like it. If you haven't been subscribed yet, please subscribe. I make videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And if you really like this video, share it with a friend or someone who you think would benefit from this information, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.